So welcome everybody. My name is Sam Wex. I'm from the Research Institute Flanders Make, a research institute in Belgium that tries to assist the manufacturing industry with optimizing the products and production processes. And for that we're of course very active also on the domain of digital twins. And we are having a project running which is called Digital Twin Design. And in that project we have developed a cloud-based digital twin for the monitoring of a clamping mechanism which is used to perform machining operations on thin composite plates. And the results of that activity I will show today to you. Maybe first, let's have a look at what is this machine we're trying to make a digital twin of, and what does it do. And why do we need it? So when you want to make holes in thin flexible composite plates, it's very important that you support these plates. And if you don't do that, you can have what they call delamination or fiber breakout, which is, let's say, poor hole quality on the sides of the drilled holes. So for big parts that are produced in high volumes, you can make dedicated supports for these type of plates that need to be manufactured, typically in, for example, aerospace. But of course, if you just want to machine low volume pieces with high variability, it's not cost effective to always make these dedicated supports. And therefore, we have developed this innovative clamping device, of which you see a movie here. So what does it do? I'll show you. So this is the drill. As you see my laser pointer, and this is let's say three suction cups which are around the drill, controlled by an additional linear motor which is put on the CNC of the drill, and these three suction cups will suck to the thin flexible plate and will support the plate while the drill is going inside the material. So there's a small little video here which you can see here. The plate goes in. And it's actually this linear motor which controls as such that the plate is supported and actually compensates for the feed forces of that drill. And here on the right you then see differences in material quality. So with this local clamping you see nice holes. Without the local clamping you can have these effects on the bottom, which you typically here see in this case at the bottom, of a poor quality of the system. We have also, of course, integrated this in a real product, which you see here, drilling of thin plates. I will start the video, you see. And you see it's drilling while not having a movement of the flexible plate. Why is this having a digital twin of this device now necessary? It's a relatively expensive material. And you want to minimize the amount of scrap material of not well drilled holes, and therefore we want to have a, let's say, a monitoring device of that monitors the quality of the drilled holes, that also keeps track of the drill wear so we can replace it in time. And also it's important to have a good idea of the correct functioning of this clamping mechanism, so if this clamping is not working properly, then also the holes will have limited quality. So it's if we monitor the clamping device, we can take action if something is damaged on this device. And next to that, very important also for this machine, is that we gather enough data and have the possibility to then later on further optimize process parameters like feed rate or drill speed to get to a faster and higher quality of the product. So we then started to make a digital twin for this machine, and you need of course a lot of data to build up the digital twin. So we have equipped our machine with some additional sensors to do this monitoring. We have added a camera that takes a picture of each drilled hole, so we can then monitor the hole quality. And we have also a measurement of the linear motor current, and this current gives us an idea of the clamping force the linear motor need to provide to avoid to compensate for the feed forces of the drill. We also have the Z position of this linear motor device, and then we can also log on the canvas the XYZ position of this CNC machine. This data will be used then for the monitoring algorithms, so later, which we develop in the cloud. And we of course add then a lot of metadata to this additionally, which will be used like feed rates, drill speeds, etc. So the first monitoring algorithm we developed was a vision-based monitoring of the hole quality of the drilled holes. Here on the left you see such a picture that the camera takes after each hole which is being drilled, and you see some small artifacts here on the inside and also here on the outside of the hole, which you want to detect and quantify to have then, let's say, a good representation of the quality of the holes. So how do we do it? We use classic computer vision, so no AI yet, but it's part of the future plan. So we do a thresholding of this image to detect the inner circle, and then we have a nice inner circle detection. And that inner circle we can then use to detect, let's say, things which are connecting to this inner circle, and also things which are below a threshold inside this inner circle. And these two things, you see this thing here, gives us an idea of some defects which are towards the inside of the circle, and these things here give us some quantification of artifacts on the outside of the circle, and this gives us some values on the quality of this hole to identify whether this hole meets the required quality. That's the first monitoring algorithm. Next to the hole quality, it's important to also monitor whether the clamping of the plate is operating as expected. So this clamping is making sure the plate is enough supported while drilling. I'll repeat this video for you, where you see that, so when the drill goes in, this linear motor on the side needs to keep up with, compensate for the feed forces of the drill. So what we know is, let's say, if this vacuum is there and this linear motor is compensating for the feed forces, we expect that the force that we measure in the clamping linear motor goes up to a certain level. If that's not the case, while we know the CNC drill is moving downwards, yeah, then we know that that something probably went wrong for keeping the plate in position. And that's what we use, this monitoring algorithm, based on a threshold we defined on drilling many holes, both with working and non-working clamping device, to detect the correct clamping operation of this adaptive clamping mechanism. Lastly, what we implemented as a monitoring algorithm is keeping track of the drill wear. Also based on the force we measure with this linear clamping device. As I said before, this linear clamping device needs to compensate for the feed forces of the drill to keep the plate in position. If it's not, then the plate will bend through. And therefore, we can have an estimate of, let's say, this clamping force, the force that the linear motor needs to provide to keep the plate in position, is an estimate of how the drill, let's say, wears out. And so on the left side, you see this clamping force as function of time during drilling when we have a new drill, and on the right side, you see, let's say, when you have a used drill, that this clamping force has significantly increased, and this is because of drill wear. So what we do is we calculate the area under this graph, actually, and we plot it over time. And then we see what you see out here. We see the evolution of the drill wear, and based on some criteria on the maximum area under here, which is related to also the drill, to the hole quality, we can identify when a drill is almost worn out and go to action and replace the drill in time. So these were the three different monitoring algorithms we have developed. Now we wanted to gather this data in the cloud and also be able to run these algorithms in the cloud, and if needed, be able to easily adapt these algorithms or fine-tune these algorithms. That's why we also wanted to run them in the cloud. So what we have done is connected our machine, which has an HPC to the Azure, Microsoft Azure Cloud. How do we do it? We have this HPC is actually sending data via MQTT to Azure IoT Hub, which is kind of a broker, and this automatically forwards the data to some functions as a service. It's called Azure Functions, which do these algorithms. So the data comes in here of each drilled hole, and then we run these two monitoring algorithms automatically, and then the output of this data goes stored in a document database of Azure Cosmos DB called. And similarly for the pictures, they arrive in a blob store on Azure, and this automatically triggers the whole quality algorithm. And this, the results of this whole quality algorithm are then again stored in the Azure Cosmos data storage. And we also store the processed images. And this data is then structured in a certain format so that it's easily accessed via queries for, or having a remote monitoring dashboard that gives a nice output to the operator. But also very important for us is having the data available for data scientists so that they can look for new correlations between process parameters and the process results to further optimize these. So we store the data in a data model. This is the typical data we store. We have production data like the feed rate, the drill speed, the sensor data, and then the resulting of the monitoring data. And this is all the data up for one single hole. And then we link this data to a plate, to a drill, and to each smart clamp. And these are linked by IDs, and then based on this we can have, let's say, a digital twin of each hole, of each plate, of each drill, and actually also of each smart clamping device. Based on that we can make some dashboarding of the digital twin of, for example, the plate. Here you see a plate with some drilled holes. On the left, this is a website which the operator can see some of the metadata of the plate, the material, the location of the holes. And on the right side, we see some visualization of whether a hole needs certain quality or whether the smart clamping was operational. Similarly, you can then click on those dashboards and go through, let's say, a digital twin I'm sorry, of each hole separately, where you can have some idea of the production data, the states of the drill wear, some time series data, as well as some indication of the whole quality based on this image processing done on the cloud. So what are our next steps we're working on now? So now we have a machine connected to the cloud, gathering data, automatically being analysis of data. As said before, it's very important for us now that data science can start to improve the production processes based on this data. We have talked to industry a lot, and what always comes up in industry is that they have often also a lot of data available, but for a data scientist, it's not always easy to find out the relations between the different data, as well as where they are stored and how to access these. So sometimes part of the data is in that type of database, part of the data is in that type of database. They need to be aware of all this type of different query languages, and that's often not so convenient for them. So what we're working on now is what we call a knowledge graph, or what literature calls a knowledge graph, is putting this information to an ontology, and in that way providing a sort of central information access for data scientists or other people who need to access the data, without having to know the lower level of the different queries. So with a single query to the knowledge graph based on, for example, GraphQL or SparkQL, you can get access to the necessary data for your analysis based and all the relations between the data are stored in this knowledge graph. That's what we're doing now. So to conclude and to show out our contributions, so what we have done is developed a digital twin of an innovative clamping device for drilling flexible composite plates. which you have seen. We have integrated three of these new monitoring algorithms for this clamping device to monitor the hole quality, monitor the correct operation of the clamping mechanism as monitoring the drill wear. We have deployed this on a commercial cloud platform called Azure of Microsoft. And yeah, we are gathering the data right now to get a better insight in the operation of this process to further optimize the process parameters. So this way we are working towards a machine which is ready to be part of a future smart factory, and we hope we can make a step for the Flemish industry this way. Thank you very much. If you have questions, feel free to contact me on this email address. Talk to you soon.